Netflix presents Surviving Hawkins, starring Maya Hawke and Sean Marr, written by Lauren Shippen.
I know.
Yeah, Buckley. Don't you want to get on this ride?
Aren't you going to do anything about this?
On or off, kid?
That's great. Just great.
Come on, Robin. Get on and maybe I'll get on.
I wish you would fall off the bus and directly into a ditch, you complete cretin. Mr. Hauser!
Miss Buckley. Is everything okay?
I wanted to, how's your week going?
Well, given that we came back from Thanksgiving 2 days ago, it's going fine.
Good. That's good.
Robin, are you sure you're all right?
Yeah. Totally.
I know that our last lunch didn't end on the best. I don't want you to think that you can't still come to me. My door's still open.
I know. I know that.
Okay. Well then, I guess I'll see you.
It's just that I'm kinda at the end of my rope, you know? Like, things keep getting completely screwed up, and even though I'm doing what I've always done, lying low and doing everything I can not to bait the monster, but none of it matters because everything keeps getting chewed up anyway, and it's been like a month since the whole thing with Milton, and it isn't fair, and Kate... Kate is supposed to stick by me, you know? She's supposed to believe in me and stuff, especially when I tell her that Dash... Oh my God, Dash... Dash can always do whatever he wants at any time, and I can't believe I told him about Operation Croissant because now I have to live with the fact that he knows and is probably making fun of me in his head all the time, and I hate that. And on top of everything, I actually finally have a job, and I think I could afford 2 people to go to Europe, but none of that will matter if I can't find someone, and all of this just feels like the universe is trying to tell me that I'm really, really not supposed to have friends. I'm really...
Do you need a ride home? The bus just left, and you really shouldn't be walking home.
I don't think I can...
And before you say anything about being overprotective, it's the middle of winter, it's gonna be dark soon. Missing kids this semester aside, you could be hit by a car.
I really don't want to put you out.
It's really okay, Robin. I'm happy to do it.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.
All right. Get on in.
Dash would sure have a lot to say about this.
What was that?
Oh, nothing. Never mind.
You know, Robin...
So, how was your Thanksgiving break?
Oh, it was good, thanks. It was really good.
Good. My Thanksgiving was a candy bar I ate during a shift at the movie theater.
That's festive. Is that the job you mentioned?
Mm-hmm. It's gonna take me the rest of the year to save up enough money for Europe, but I think I can get there.
That's great, Robin.
Yeah. It's a good start.
How are the other parts of the plan going? The list? You said some things about your friends.
Mind if we listen to some music?
No, go right ahead.
Come on. The radio in this town sucks. Do you have anything that we could play?
Yeah, there's a tape case on the floor there.
Whoa, you really are a big Culture Club fan, huh?
I told you I listen to music a lot.
Queen, David Bowie, Cher. Oh my God, seriously, Madonna?
What's wrong with Madonna?
I mean, I don't know. I just didn't picture you as someone who's obsessed with the new.
I wanted to know what all the fuss was about.
And?
And I think Lauper's better.
Correct answer. Kate loves Madonna. She's been trying to get me into her for months.
And you're not a fan?
I like listening to stuff because my friends like it. A song can become special when the right person likes it.
Yeah, it can.
It's not that I don't like music, by the way. I do. I like music.
Okay.
I didn't want you to think I was anti-music or anything.
Robin, you're in marching band. I never thought that. But for the record, it'd be okay if you were. You're allowed to like what you like and dislike what you dislike, and those things don't have to be the same as everyone else.
I know that. I've been trying to take your advice.
Which part of it?
Yeah, you really do give me a lot of advice, don't you?
Maybe you need it. So which nugget of wisdom have you been following?
Trying to focus on things that I enjoy in the here and now, instead of just waiting to get out.
And? How's it going?
It's okay. You were right. I like languages. I like reading. I used to like riding my bike around until my parents took that away from me.
I don't think I said to focus on the things you like but can't
do. Okay. I like learning new songs in the French horn. We got to do a new number at the game last Friday, and it was really, really fun.
Sounds it.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, it just feels like every time I'm enjoying something, marching band or watching MTV or, yes, my bike, it gets taken away.
I know marching band is over for the season, but last I checked, MTV was very much still on.
It's not the same.
The same as what?
It was just... MTV is one of those things that's special because of the person who likes it.
I see.
And Hawkins just keeps chewing those things up and spitting them out. It's chewing me up.
Robin, I don't mean to pry.
I think we're well past that.
I've gathered that things have been hard with your friends this semester.
Oh yeah, did you pick up on that?
Do you have anyone you can talk to about this stuff? People your own age, I mean. Not that I'm not happy to be a confidant, I just think it's good to have somebody who really understands what you're going through.
I thought you really understood what I was going through.
I like to think I do. My teenage years weren't that long ago.
Honestly, it's amazing you have decent taste in music at all, given that you grew up in the 70s.
I'm going to choose to focus on the compliment part of that statement. But you're not wrong. The 70s, they were tough. And I remember how hard being 15 is, but that doesn't mean I can perfectly relate to everything you're going through right now.
I'm not sure people my own age can relate to what I'm going through.
Maybe not. But it's always worth giving people a chance.
I don't know. Maybe I just can't keep friends. Barb in middle school, now the Odd Squad.
The Odd Squad?
Oh, it's a stupid band group name thing. It's dumb.
What happened with them? Things seem okay with you, Milton. I saw the two of you talking in the hallway the other week. It seemed like whatever's going on, maybe it could be repaired.
I don't know that it's even totally broken. But maybe that's not the problem. Maybe I'm broken. What if there's just something about me that drives people away?
Robin, why on earth would you think that?
Because I can't seem to keep any friends. And before you say anything about how that's just how it goes when you're a teenager, that people fall in and out of friendships every other semester, just don't. Because it really doesn't seem like that's the case for anyone but me. And it's not that I expect to find, like, my people in Hawkins, but I had at least found a few who made the surviving a little bit easier.
And sometimes that's enough.
Yeah, except that it didn't last again. And the only common denominator through all of this is me. There's something wrong with me. There's something inside of me that's just, like, rotten. And there's nothing I can do to fix it. Wait, why are you stopping?
Robin, look at me. There is nothing wrong with you.
You have to say that.
No. I'm serious. Hey. Hey. Look me in the eye and trust what I'm saying, okay? There is nothing wrong with you. There is nothing rotten inside of you. You don't need to be fixed. Okay?
You called me the weirdest girl in Hawkins for a reason.
Because you're your own person. I did mean it as a compliment. Just because some people might not understand you doesn't mean there's anything wrong with the way you are. And despite what you think, you know who you are. As much as anyone can at your age, anyway.
Is that supposed to be comforting?
I'm not going to lie and tell you that life is going to be easy for you. People like... Sometimes people who know their own minds, who are who they are without asking other people's permission, it can be hard. It can be alienating. But don't let other people's small-mindedness make you feel bad about yourself. There is nothing wrong with the way you are. Okay? And you don't need to change yourself, no matter what anyone ever says.
I mean, no one's ever really said anything like that before. Not to my face, anyway. I'm really not being bullied.
So that wasn't Roy shouting lewd comments at you?
That's not bullying. That's just a meathead being a meathead.
If you want me to talk to him...
Roy really isn't the problem.
Or talk to anyone.
I thought I was supposed to be confiding in people my own age.
Yeah. Well, until you find someone you want to take a chance on, I'm here. I am always here for you, Robin.
Thanks, Mr. Hauser. That's really nice of you. Shouldn't we keep driving?
Right, of course. Sorry, I got a bit carried away there.
No, it's okay. I've caught you in another lie, though.
What do you mean?
You said life wasn't full of rousing speeches. And that was pretty close.
Curses, you figured me out. Life is all about rousing speeches.
You're such a dork.
Come on. Admit it, my dorkiness is half the reason you like talking to me.
Yeah, you keep telling yourself that. So, what else do you like besides Madonna? I told you mine.
I like all kinds of things. I'm a well-rounded person.
Okay, but what specifically? Baking, knitting, street racing, Satanism?
Well, the culture club. Going to the movies.
Right, Tom Cruise.
And I enjoy doing the newspaper crossword.
Wow.
Boring?
So boring.
Sorry to disappoint, but I don't need a lot. Teaching really is my raison d'être.
Seriously?
Nothing makes you happier than helping young minds appreciate Lord of the Flies.
Well, that's gotta be easy in Hawkins. I'm pretty sure everyone here can relate to being trapped on a desert island.
I do shudder to think what would happen if the students of Hawkins High were left to their own devices.
Yeah. Speaking of, look, the other day, Okay, first things first, I was a total dingus during our last lunch, and I'm really sorry.
If you were being a dingus, I think I was also being a dingus.
It's weird to hear you say dingus.
It felt weird to say it.
But I meant it, you know? You can talk to me about stuff too, if you want. Not just your love of crosswords, but like real stuff.
That's kind of you, but I don't think that'd be appropriate.
Well, do you have people you can talk to? People your own age?
Yes, Robin, I do.
Oh. Good for you, then.
And you will find your people, too. I know you will.
Have you told any of your people about the phone calls? That's what I was gonna say. After you left to go to the library, the phone rang again and I picked up.
Robin...
Before you get on me about spying, I thought it was just the librarian calling back and I was gonna tell her you were on your way. I was being helpful.
Well... Was it the librarian?
No.
Perfect.
It was your mystery caller, saying stuff.
What kind of stuff?
Like weird stuff. Stuff that makes me think I'm not the one we should be worried about in regards to bullying.
I appreciate the concern, Robin, but I have it under control.
So you know who it is?
No, but I'm not sure it matters. I've dealt with this kind of thing before. I know how to handle it.
What kind of thing? Are mysterious phone calls something you're dealing with regularly?
At every school I've ever taught at, there's been someone who hasn't wanted me there.
What? Why?
Wait, the caller still said something, even though it wasn't me picking up?
Yeah. And they knew it was me. Which is very creepy.
Tell me exactly what they said to you.
They were warning me.
Warning you about what?
I don't know. They weren't specific. Do you know?
I thought I did. Now.
Mr. Hauser? You still breathing there?
Yeah. Yeah, yes. Sorry, I can't say I've ever been in this particular scenario before.
And what scenario is that?
Robin, I'm sorry to have dragged you into whatever this is. I don't want to be the reason that you get chewed up and spit out by the monster.
You're basically the only thing keeping me from getting swallowed whole at the moment.
This is your street, right?
Yeah. I'm just right up there. That's the house. You can pull into the driveway if you want.
That's okay. I don't want your parents to see me in panic about a strange man driving their teenage daughter home.
You're not a strange man.
Not to you.
Trust me, my parents let strange people into their house all the time. Their friends, they have weird hippie friends.
Right.
Well, thanks for the ride.
Sure.
I'll see you at lunch tomorrow.
Maybe, you know, just try getting lunch with Milton or Tam.
Yep, okay, great. I'll see you at lunch tomorrow.
Okay. But we are not talking about running away or secrets or any of that stuff anymore. Strictly academic, right?
Oh, come on, that's no fun.
Oh, really? You mean you don't want to talk about the parallels between Lord of the Flies and Hawkins High? You can tell me why you think Steve Harrington is Ralph or
whatever. Oh my god, Steve is totally not Ralph. He's definitely Jack Meridew. You did that on purpose, didn't you?
It's very easy to provoke you into instantly proving my point.
Fine. You're on. Tomorrow, lunch. You're getting Hawkins High students as Lord of the Flies characters.
I can't wait.
Bonsoir, Mr. Hauser.
Au revoir, Robin.
Surviving Hawkins is a production of Netflix and Atypical Artists and is a companion podcast to the novel Stranger Things, Rebel Robin by A.R. Capetta from Random House Children's Books, starring Maya Hawke as Robin Buckley and Sean Marr as Mr. Hauser, written and directed by Lauren Shippen. In this episode, you also heard the voices of Emily Kirk as Bus Driver and Josh Rubino as Roy. Editing and sound design by Brandon Grugel. Lillian Holman is our production manager. And if you haven't already, go read Rebel Robin to get the full story behind Robin's friendship with Mr. Hauser and how she managed to survive sophomore year.